Welcome to the Crafty Toads. We have not been around for so long. It's been,
I think it was about a month.
Oh my god. It's been so long.
But it was December, so.
December is crazy in our house.
December doesn't exist.
December is just
madness.
You
just close your eyes and hope you make it through.
Yeah, that's it. So, we did. We made it through the other end. We made it out. Live, semi-alive at any rate. So, welcome to the Crafty Toads. This is the Crafty Toad Podcast. And we are a podcast about knitting and now crocheting and sewing and all kinds of good stuff.
Yeah.
And we are coming to you from New Jersey. We are the creators behind Toad Hollow Bags and now Toad Hollow Yarn. And I suppose we should introduce ourselves.
I say we're sisters. We've hung a picture since we last spoke to you. We actually hung pictures in our house.
Yeah. So. It's starting to look like a home. 2.5 years in. This is about our gypsy blood.
It's like, okay, yeah. Maybe we'll stay.
So what we do is we get to about 2.5 years, we hang all the pictures, and then move in 3 months. It's ready to time to go. But hopefully we're going to stay here a little bit because we really like the house and the yard, and our landlord's kind of cool too. So, but I am Mary Beth. You can find me all over as MaryBeth494, mostly on Instagram and Ravelry. That's where I hang out.
I am Helen. You can find me as HelenHG69 on Instagram and Ravelry.
And you can find the businesses Toad Hollow and Jay. We are on Etsy. We have a website, which pretty much directs you back to Etsy. And we sometimes...
It's separate.
I'm sorry. Okay. ToadHollowandJay.com. But you can find us on Etsy, too. And we also, every now and then, Periscope. Like...
What? September?
Twice. Three times, maybe. It may be something for the new year. We don't know. We keep talking about it, and who knows what will happen. But that's us.
We got into podcasting this year. Maybe this year will be the year of Periscope.
That's right.
Because I never would have figured we'd podcast.
And here we are.
Yeah.
We have two dogs, Spike and Drusilla. They are...
currently inhaling a bribe.
So hopefully they will be quiet. We also have two cats that over the past two episodes have introduced themselves, usually butt first. So who knows what you're going to see. Although Helen put up a picture on Instagram of our island. I don't think there's room for a cat right now.
If it jumps...
The island's going down.
I was gonna say, the first thing that goes is the iPad, which then the cat will go.
Right. And it's like 20 degrees outside. Right. You don't want to go outside. Anyway... we have a whole list full of things. Do you have any idea what episode we're on?
20...
something.
Two? I think we turned 21 last
plus?
Time.
That's right, we did. We turned 21. Oh. So I think we're on 22, episode 22. We have a group in Ravelry called the Crafty Toads that you can find us in, all sorts of good things going on there. And is there anything else that we need to talk about?
Did you read it?
Back of Helen's head.
Sorry. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Like I said, madness. Absolute madness.
It was January 5th, 2017.
Wow.
Not only is it Happy New Year, we're 5 days in.
Yeah.
And we're supposed to get our first snow of the season tonight.
Tonight. So. We're driving up to Montclair.
Yeah,
so
no big deal.
Be driving back in the snow.
No, we won't.
No, we're going to make it back before then?
Yeah. It's okay. It's going to start tonight. And we're going to make sure we make it back before then.
Back before then. All right. So not looking forward to that?
No, this is not... the first snow is not a good thing.
Second snow, fourth snow, no, thank you.
Yeah, what? So, spring?
Yes.
What do we figure? Not 6 Mondays, maybe.
I know! I put up something on Instagram that's got this really cute picture that spring six Mondays from now. Really not. Probably, like, 10 Mondays?
Yeah, I mean, it depends on where you are. Maybe some places... Florida spring training is 6 Mondays from now.
Okay.
So...
I should just change it.
Yeah.
And put spring training is in 6 Mondays. Because really, I was thinking about it after I put it up because I didn't bother to count. I just thought, oh, this is such a cute graphic. I'm going to share it. And then...
The internet. It must be true.
It must be true. I was talking to Helen. I'm like, wait a minute. No, that just puts us in February. That's not right. I'm pretty sure,
that
you know, spring is
in
March.
You know, hell.
Yeah. So, sorry, everybody, if I got your hopes up. Spring is not in 6 weeks.
Maybe 12 weeks.
I should know this because I taught kindergarten, and I know that Groundhog's Day is February 2nd. February 2nd, and it's always, if he sees his shadow, it's 6 months from then. Or 6 weeks.
Oh my god.
6 weeks from
then. Let's move on.
Okay, because this is getting so convoluted. All right, moving on, what do we got?
We did a New Year's giveaway on Instagram.
Actually, we were
Kind of blew us away.
Yeah, well, we were doing a Christmas, our countdown to Christmas. It was our 25 days leading up to Christmas, and we did something each day that had Christmassy things. And then we were supposed to do the giveaway on Christmas, and
but we decided,
our brains were
No. I made a conscious decision not to, because Christmas is a day for family, and I wanted people to do specific things to qualify for the giveaway, because it's a big giveaway. And I didn't want it to be all about, you know, me. So we gave people their Christmas. There was a conscious thought in there that I didn't want to make it like, you know, hey, look at me on Christmas when you should be spending time with your family.
Okay.
So we decided to do it for New Year's. We had a picture. We put a picture on Instagram. We are giving away this lovely basket.
This is one of our yarn baskets.
It's a fabric yarn basket. Lovely Paris theme.
Little towards me. Perfect. Okay. It's got bikes.
Cats inside, and then you will also get two skeins of our yarn, one of which is the Winter Raven.
This is the Winter Raven. We gave this as a present to a friend of ours, and she brought it to Trivia last night showing us how she's knitting it.
Gorgeous.
Oh my god, it's so, nice. Pretty. It's like black with streaks of red and green. Oh, it's gorgeous. It's really, really pretty.
So you get Winter Raven, and then also Tika's coat, which is this lovely midnight blue with reds and green.
As Helen said, you guys blew us away.
Oh my god.
We not
had
only
over 200, no,
199 likes.
Over comments.
199 comments, well over 200 likes.
Yeah, we gained like 250 new followers. It
and
was just awesome.
You put us over 1,000 followers on Instagram, which
we may
was
have
just
to
like,
do another
whoa.
Giveaway right away. So we are going to announce the winner of the giveaway.
So
because we chose
two skeins of yarn.
We had Siri choose our star winner.
So we did between $2 and $199, and Siri picked number 49, which was
Lone Star Knitter.
Congratulations, Carolyn, right?
Carolyn, and she's Zoo Kyla on Ravelry.
Right.
She's a zookeeper in Texas.
Awesome!
And, I mean, we kind of stalked you a little.
Well, we went in and checked you out. You've got some horses, some dogs, chickens, you know.
She's got over, 20
awesome.
Chickens, 10
yes.
acres of land. So, Carolyn, I'm keeping the prize because you're living my life.
No, really.
Please get in touch with us on Instagram.
Private messages.
DM us on Instagram, or you can get in touch with us on Ravelry. Either way, just let us know your address, and we will get this out to you.
Yeah, we'll put it in the mail. So congratulations.
And thank you, everybody, so much for following us and
sharing the post and everything.
Joining in the giveaway.
Thank you very much.
We will do more.
Yes. All right. So we just need to find a place to put that now that that's done, because it's like there is no room. Anywhere.
Carolyn, get in touch with me fast. I have no room.
Your prize is in the sink right now. No, I'm just kidding. It's not. But it is the only clean space right now.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on.
Moving on.
All right.
Brief interlude for dogs.
It is an ongoing occurrence here.
Well, part of it is we haven't podcasted in a while, so they're not used to their podcast behavior either.
Yeah.
So if anybody is our faithful watchers,
that.
You know that they've never really been podcast.
Behavior.
Podcast behavior is
bad.
Look at me. I'm a child. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Anyway, so we were saying that we've had a crazy, crazy December, and we were just very busy setting out the dog pillows, doing bags for knitting stores.
We originally planned that it was going to be, we were doing wholesale stuff, so end of November, everything was going to be delivered. We were actually going to have a December where we could decorate the house and do things for Christmas, make Christmas cookies, go, you know, Christmas shopping that was relaxed and comfortable. And no, it doesn't work like that. Not at all. The dog pillow that we showed you the last time, we actually sent out our last dog pillow on December 23rd. We delivered some pillows that we made to a lady here in town on December 23rd. We were delivering bags to yarn stores.
I think on December 23rd.
It was pretty close.
Yeah, yeah, I mean,
yeah, it was like December 22nd. Yeah. But anyway, all very good.
Shopping. We also have a month full of birthdays in our family.
Yes.
Of which mine was one.
Very important.
And the last one is the 20th. And then pretty much from then forward, we were helping my mom get ready for Christmas.
So it was just
and
crazy.
Doing all our stuff. And what we figured, we drove back and forth to Montclair.
10 times over 11 days. Also,
it's
we
not
chose
a thing. It's just
to actually, we closed the store in mid-November, but the landlord was really cool about letting us leave furniture there until the last week of December. So we made it through Christmas and immediately went into moving furniture out of the store into a storage place. So it was just between December 16th and New Year's Day, it was nonstop. Every day we were driving somewhere and doing things.
Extended family stay, and
I would not recommend this at all. So then, January 1st,
take out the store part of it.
Yeah,
and
January 1st, we basically had a mini nervous breakdown. January 1st and 2nd, it was knitting, sleeping.
I was gonna say sleeping.
Lots
first.
Of sleeping, reading. Got some reading done. Mm-hmm. So it was. January 1st and 2nd were like the most ideal days. We didn't have to see anybody, we didn't have to do anything, and it was just sit, knit, read,
sleep,
doze for a while,
repeat,
watch some podcasts, get caught up on some podcasts, watch some
binge
TV,
watch some Australian TV.
Yeah, we got a couple of Australian TV programs.
Yeah,
that just we loved. So
it was just really very nice.
Oh, it was so nice.
We got to plan a little bit for what we have planned for the new year.
Yes.
Cast on some new things, which we'll show in our whips, but we have grand plans for the new year.
Yes.
As far as what we're going to knit,
what we're
going to do. We got fancy, because, you know, this is going to work
for probably 2 weeks.
We got planners.
These are not Erin Condren planners, but I think
they're fairly
knockoffs.
Close, because we were looking at Erin Condren's, and they're really pretty close.
We got ours from Michael's.
Half price.
On sale. But you can see, look.
You get the month at a glance.
You get the week. Start filling in things.
That's much better
stickers.
Than I am.
She gets
so excited about her.
So, I mean, it's just... We went to Trivia last night and came first. Which is very exciting because it's like the third time in a row that we've been there and we've taken third place. And this time... Taken first place. And this time, the guy who hosts it said, you guys didn't stand a chance. Like, oh yeah. That's us. So we have a group of five that does it and it's awesome.
It's a lot of fun. This is mine. I'm not nearly as fancy with my stickers yet.
See?
But I'm going to have a very organized life. But we're going to be organized. We're going to plan out our knitting.
I did. Here is my knitting plans right down here for January. That's just January. So it's very cool.
We're going to try and make more of our food. Not like,
right.
You know, like from scratch or anything, but we, with our crazy December, there was a hell of a lot of takeout.
Really bad eating.
Really just bad eating, so
and
we want to...
And it was things that you don't feel good, and by
it
the
doesn't
time,
taste good, because we have no good takeout places there.
So that it's just, it's...
And pretty much to the point where we pull up to McDonald's and they're like, the usual, but they're not
that's
really.
So sad.
But it's really very sad. I had not
so
eaten
sad.
McDonald's. For a good, I'd say 20, 25 years. And then a five-year-old entered my life, and...
When somebody says to you, I think we should go have lunch at a place that has an emblem,
you
and
know,
you look at
like
him
McDonald's.
And say, an emblem, and he said, an emblem that looks like McDonald's, you're like, okay.
Yeah.
For you, kid, I will do anything. So. And then we just realized, this is so easy.
Yeah.
We're driving here. Let's stop at McDonald's and get lunch. Or, you know, we haven't eaten breakfast.
It just lends itself to very, very poor habits. And
yes.
You more than me, but we both kind of enjoy cooking. And it tastes so much better.
So what did I do today? I made snacks.
Emergency snacks.
Elevator Lady Spice Cookies. Peg Bracken's I Hate to Cookbook. I don't know if you guys remember it. It's from the 50s.
Best spice cook.
Most awesome cookie. Spice cookies ever.
Addictive.
They are in a bowl that my brother and sister-in-law brought us back from Mexico, and it is my favorite cookie bowl. And so we have Elevator Lady Spice Cookies.
So we have homemade goodies, and we're going to make our own dinners. And Mary Beth gave me a journal for my birthday where we're going to keep track of the really good recipes that we really like because we're going to try new recipes and that kind of thing. So all grand scheme for 2017. And
we are on January 5th.
Talk to us.
We have made a grand total of...
chicken and rice.
One dinner. However... That dinner lasted. We'll know it lasted one day.
We did do pasta and spaghetti sausage.
Two dinners. We did two dinners. Okay, so 2 out of 5.
And last night
we were at the pub.
Trivia. We go out to eat. We're gonna be with my mom tonight, and more than likely we'll order stuff.
No, we're making pasta.
No, I know, but that's not gonna work. So
why not,
Damien?
He'll make his own thing.
Anyway.
Talks amongst yourselves. We're talking amongst ourselves.
We're talking in code.
Right.
But the good thing about being sisters is we understand each other perfectly.
Yeah. So
anyway.
There you
moving
go.
Moving on. FOs?
FOs.
We gave them all away.
So, craziness of December and everything. December 20th, what do we decide to do?
I think, give us a little more credit.
It was wasn't.
No, I think it was a week before. It was the Sunday.
No, I don't think
it was the Sunday. It was the week before.
So the 19th?
Maybe the 18th was a week before. 18th was a week before.
Okay. So December 18th, what do we decide to do?
Everybody's getting a hat.
We're going to make handmade things to give out because we knit now. So we're making handmade things to give out.
I was already almost done the socks for my mom.
Helen decided she was going to make a pair of socks. Christina from the Cozy Knitter, we bought a set of her gingerbread yarn. And Helen very, very kindly decided she was going to make the socks for my mom.
And I finished them and I gave them to her. And she loves them.
She does. She absolutely loves them. But
excuse me, I'm putting my planner on the floor.
So Helen was working on the socks and then we decided everybody's getting a hat. We're making people handmade items for Christmas. This was insane.
Did I mention that we're crazy?
And really, really tired then.
But we got three of them done.
Yes. Well, we see, the thing was, Amber from the Yarn Hoarder put up a picture of the hats that she made for her husband and his friend.
She was making them in a couple hours, so how hard could it be?
Right. It's not. It's a really simple pattern. It's on her Ravelry page. It's a piece of cake.
She makes much faster than we do.
Yes. And, you know, but we made three hats.
Yep.
And gave them to people for Christmas.
I will insert a picture because I did manage to take a picture of the hats before I give them away.
So we... made Green Bay Packers for my brother. Baltimore Ravens for my sister-in-law and the New Jersey Devils for my other brother.
Yeah.
And they looked so cool.
Yeah.
And my brother and sister-in-law.
And we have been commissioned for another one from our other brother.
Right. Brother number 3 wants one too. So. But my sister and brother-in-law, brother and sister-in-law loved them. They were so
gratifying.
They put them on because we had done the test knit with the Superfan scarf in their colors too. So it was perfect. The hat and the scarf went together. Yeah. Really, really well.
And he walked, when he left,
excuse me.
He walked out. What, you have hair in your mouth?
I have a dog hair in my mouth. I don't know how that happened. But they were
Christine
wearing them.
Household?
So, yeah, it was very, very cool. And we were knitting the devil's hat for my brother John. My brother Larry is the one who is the Green Bay Packers, but he also is a huge Rangers fan. And he is the one who has the sons, Brayden and Cullen. And Brayden was here. They both were here with us.
Part of our Christmas mayhem, the week after Christmas, we got a day with the nephews.
Right.
His parents went off to a concert.
Helen's knitting the New Jersey, the devil's hat. And we got Brayden.
First he called them those losers.
Right.
And we said,
the bad guys.
They're the bad guys. They're the bad guys because he's a Rangers fan like his dad. And Mary Beth said, no, when they play the Rangers, they're not the bad guys. And he got very mad at Mary Beth because he said, don't you talk about my daddy's team like that. But then,
when Larry his came father back. Came
to kick him up, he went up to his father and told him, when the Devils and the Rangers play, the Rangers are the losers. This was the best moment ever.
Larry's face, it was just total shell shock.
He was just like, I was gone for 24 hours. What did you do?
You had him for less than 24 hours.
And now you can keep him.
You bring him. And then Brady was like, oh, no, 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 Daddy, no, Daddy, the Rangers and the cookies.
But it was a priceless moment.
It was. The look on his face, it was because he takes sports so serious.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, moving on, because we haven't even gotten to our whips, and we're halfway through our time on... Three hats, one pair of socks, done, handed out, given, and we have a commission for another hat. So those are our things. But we are going to start doing our whips, because as we said on New Year's Day, we did kind of cast on a couple of things, and we've been working on other things. So, shall we start with socks?
Sure.
Okay. I am going to start with my opal socks. I have shown these before. I started these at the beginning of December, and I was going to do them two at a time.
You were going to give those away, too.
Yes, I was, and then I cast on the wrong number of stitches and got really excited about them and decided I was keeping them for myself. So, this is opal yarn. It is 400 grams, 425 meters, 75% superwash, 25% polyamide, and it is... I believe the colorway is number 1430, but I have gotten them. I was going to do them two at a time and then put them on the same, you know, do the cuffs and then put them on the same needle, and that didn't work out. So I am now doing it that I have two sets of needles going, one from the middle, pulling from the middle, and one from the end. This one, I'm kind of doing them in tandem now. So this one I have gotten down and I have done my heel and turned the heel and picked up the stitches for my gussets. And I just am now have to decrease for the gusset and go straight down the foot. This one I am about to pick up the stitches for my heel, or about to start doing the heel. So this one is now on hold until I get this one to the heel turn and pick up everything, and then I will do them in tandem going down the foot. So 64 stitches on size 2, I believe.
One Hiya.
Those are Hiyas, and I believe these are Knit Pro Zings. There's a huge, huge difference in the points, because this is my Knit Pro Zing. This is the Hiya Sharps. And boy, do I notice it when I start knitting. After using the Knit Pros, when I start after the using the Hiyas, because the Knit Pros are much, much thicker
and duller.
Yeah, so
the Hiyas you could actually like hurt yourself.
Actually, I do. I have a puncture in my finger from using pointy needles. But so two socks, getting to the point where I'm about to do my heel, and then hopefully it will not take too much longer, and I will have pair number 4
on the books.
I really love them. My mom got so excited about watching me knit these at one point that we went to visit Christina at Chelsea Yarns and picked up a skein for her for Christmas. It was one of her Christmas presents. And so she gets to do her own because she is now a sock knitter.
Maybe.
We're going up to Montclair to help her do her heels.
She's gotten her first heel and it's not going well.
Yeah, so we have to go and help her do her heels today. But... that's what's going on after this.
These are my opal socks. I had not started them the last time we podcast, which was months ago, but this is as far as I have gotten. These are pretty much my core knitting. So I've got another couple repeats before I drop my heel, and I'm just doing them one at a time. I'm doing 60 stitches on size 2 because I have found that the 64 is just a little too big. So 2017 is going to be the year of me perfecting my sock size.
Okay.
So I'm trying 60 stitches on this one and the next pair that I'll show. And we'll see how they work. So.
They're beautiful.
Yeah.
I love the pattern.
The opal yarn is so much fun to knit. It's like knitting self-striping socks. You have no idea what's coming. next and where it's going to, and I mean, you can see that the repeats, because this is still a new, the one that I'm on now is still a new repeat, one that I haven't done before. So it's just so much fun.
Yeah. Really great.
I will knit a lot of these.
Yeah. Like those.
They're a scratchier wool than some of your super wash. But
we're kind of hoping that it's going to...
I think it'll soften with blocking and also, you know, wool socks are good.
Yes. So. Especially with weather that's coming.
Yeah. Did we mention there's no problem?
Okay. My second pair of socks is... I have decided I am going to try and try pattern socks. We are doing the Naughty Knitwits... Sock-a-thon.
Socket.
2017 socket?
Yep.
And so I cast on a pair of business casual socks. This is, as far as I've gotten, all I've done so far is the ribbing. But it is a 2x2 rib. And I am doing these on size 2... Not Chow Goose.
I don't know, they're random.
Okay, size 2 random needles. These are in Vivid Yarn. They are... The colorway is Crazy Quilt. It is 80% superwash, 20% nylon. 400 yards for a 100 gram ball. That's so fun. Looks like. This is how it's knitting so far.
Thank you, Teresa.
They are from Teresa, who gave me the wool as a gift, which was so sweet of her. And I wrote everything on the back so that I would be able to do it. They are the Business Casual Socks by Tanis Fiber Arts. So, very exciting so far. I think it's going to be even more exciting when I start the pattern.
Yeah.
However, I cast this on a New Year's Day and knit my ribbing. And that part is done for sock number 1, so now I have to start the actual sock. But I thought, finish my other socks first, if I possibly can, and hopefully still get these done.
No, hopefully you have to.
Yes.
Even if you have to put other things aside, socks will be done.
Socks will be done. Well, Sue today on her Periscope from Sue is Knit 24. She was talking about how she really wants 365 pairs of socks because she wants a different pair of socks for every day. I think that is an awesome idea. So I have 3 pairs done. I only have to knit 362 more.
Piece of cake.
No problem.
I am doing the blueberry waffle sock because I've never done that before.
Do you want me to hold something?
I'm good.
Okay.
I'm using my Once Upon a Corgi Christmas yarn. It's peppermint
mocha,
I believe. Yes, peppermint mocha on her ginger base, which is 75 superwash, 20 nylon, and 5 gold Selena. So these are, and I did the cuff out of marinated yarns. I had a little mini of hers, which she calls marionettes. So I did the cuff. It's a 2x2 twisted rib, again 60 stitches, and I'm getting pretty close to dropping my heel again.
That is really pretty.
It is. It's gorgeous, and I really love the squishy of the blueberry waffle on it. I mean, it's a piece of the pattern is a piece of cake. So,
but very squishy, really nice.
Yeah. So I'm very interested to finish them and see how they feel on, because in the pattern. They say that the broken rib pattern makes them stay up. So
really,
we'll see if that works.
Yeah, huh.
I would think that the squishy would make them slouch more. But
does anybody else remember slouchy socks from the 80s? Loved my slouchy socks from the 80s. I want to make this a thing that comes back. And those would be perfect.
Yeah.
That would be, because those are kind of like what they were like.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of pattern. So I think we need to make that come back. You know, really tall, slouchy socks that you wear pushed around your ankles.
Anyway, these are my blueberry.
I have them in every color.
Blueberry waffle socks. So I try and get a little bit done each night. I'm trying to work my, do a little bit on each of my projects. So since I have time sensitiveness on some of them.
Yeah.
So, but lots of fun to knit.
Yes.
And again, random size 2 needles that we had lying around. I don't know where our chabus are.
Yeah, but where did we get all these random needles?
I don't know.
We didn't, I mean, last April, we were working on
Susan Boyle. So I
had Blake?
Boyle?
Susan Boyle's the singer.
Yeah, I don't know, whatever.
Joanne's needles that you can't do the magic loop in.
Yeah.
Anyway. Okay. All right, next whip. Moving on. Okay. I have to reach to get this. Excuse me.
Do you want me to do it? She's reaching because she can't put her feet down because, you know, there's a dog.
This and is...
the old adage about letting them lie.
This is my Mrs. Weasley sweater. I have a leaning tower of everything. Random crochet hook just stuck through. Poor sweater, it's like it's been stabbed.
Poor sweater's just like finished me already.
I know. Alright, so my Mrs. Weasley sweater now has not only one, but two sleeves done! Look at that! Two sleeves finished! I'm so excited. I tried it on. I think I have to add about 6 inches down the back. So that it hits me where I want it to hit. So right now, I figure I get about 1 inch per color. So I'm 1, 2.5 in. So I have about 3.5 inches more to do. And then I have to do the ribbing and do the whole button band madness. But this is what we are doing with our minis. Last year when people started doing the Cozy Memories blankets, we decided we were going to make a sweater out of ours. And this is... what we're working on. This is how it looks. So
it's the Lifesaver sweater pattern by Tanis Fiber Arts.
It's awesome.
It is just really, and the end is in sight.
Yes, it actually is getting to the point where I think I may finish this. Because for a while there,
before it gets warm again, I may finish this.
Questionable. Actually, this is when I tried it on. It's very light. Because it's fingering weight, but it's so warm. Yeah. It's so warm and comfy. So
it's perfect to wear around the house.
Yeah, just wrap around yourself. And it's also going to be perfect for the spring. So it's just, it's so cool. This is my coat of many colors.
I was going to say it is the coat of many colors.
I will be singing Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat when I wear this, but it's just, I love it. So this is what I have been working on, and I am getting there. Definitely getting there. Threads and hairs and everything. So
nothing a good blocking won't fix?
No.
Look at you, you can fold it.
I know. It's actually a sweater shape. Very excited about it.
This is my... I have one complete sleeve.
Ta-da!
And I am...
You are almost done.
About 30 rows, which will go very quickly because they're getting smaller and smaller and smaller, to go on my second sleeve. And I have my body is just about to where I think where I want it. Because when I finished the first sleeve, I tried it on. And I think it's about where I need... I'm going to turn it so they can see the back.
Okay.
I think it's about where I want it to be, plus the ribbing. So then once I finish my 30 stitches, then I get to do the ripping on the bottom and then start picking up the button band. And I'm really actually starting to get very excited about the fact that this may be done soon.
I know. And a carryover from when we had the store, we sold pewter buttons in the shape of animals, which I have upstairs.
Yeah.
So that when we get our button bands done, I actually have buttons that we can put on them.
And I got buttons in my Christmas swap package from Stacy. Thank you very much, Stacy.
Oh, cool.
I love my package. And they're owl buttons. So
they're going to be perfect.
They may be perfect for my son.
Okay. Wow. So. Exciting stuff.
As I sit and read in the morning with my cup of tea, I've been working on my sleep. And it's coming along very quickly.
It is. It's coming along beautifully.
I'm reading a very good book, so.
Okay. All right. My last whip is a shawl that I started. I am doing the 100 Acre Shawl by Helen Stewart. 100 Acre Wood Shawl by Helen Stewart. It is a paid pattern. So as Helen said, we're not going to show you anything that's paid. But I am doing this as a gift for someone, a friend of mine, who gave us a gift over Christmas. She just stopped by one day and knocked on the door and gave us a snowman because she knows I love snowmen, and we lost almost all our snowmen in Hurricane Irene, and so she decided she was going to help me start up my project again, or my collection again, and she dropped off a snowman, which was very, very sweet of her. So I am making her the 100 acre wood shawl. This is our yarn. It's called Vintage Candy, and the more I knit of it, the more I love it. It is so pretty.
It is just gorgeous.
Are you getting the colors?
Yeah, it
I
is.
I can't see.
Yeah. It is just knitting beautifully. I'm so excited. Between you doing this and seeing Heather do the Winter Raven, it's just like, oh my God, we created beautiful yarn.
I know. Barbara, this is how it's knitting up. Yep. Look at this. It's so gorgeous. I absolutely love it. I am going to be dyeing more of this because I need this in a shawl for me. It's going to be very difficult to give away. I am doing the small pattern or the small size for this because it's going to be
small size so that she can wear it as a scarf when she goes walking her dogs and things like that. I just love it. I really, really, really love it. I love the pattern. It's a lot of fun to knit. There are different stitches and things. There are things that make beads. And
Helen Stewart's patterns are great because she always gives you multiple sizes.
Right.
And
I'm just going to do, I'm going to show like this. Okay, so what she does is she gives you the instructions on one side, then she's got how many stitches you should have in each of the row, in the row, and then the percentage done. So it's just, it's fantastic.
So,
it really is.
I mean, easy to keep track of where you should be. Because there are lots of yarn overs and, you know, just increasing out. So I love her patterns.
Yeah, I really, really do. This is the, well, I finished one of hers, and then this is the second one that I'm going to actually finish on time. I started the Talisman Shawl, and I didn't get terribly far with it because I got sidetracked by other things, but this is...
And we have all of her because we joined her shawl society.
Right, so we got the secret shawls.
We did her advent.
The her knit vent.
So we got all of those patterns.
Yeah, so we've got quite a few.
Yeah, but I'm like about a third of the way through the amulet, so.
They're beautiful. They are absolutely beautiful. So that's what I've been working on. I've been working on this pretty steadily because I'm going to see my friend at book club coming up, and I want to have this done, if not before, then definitely by book club. So I want to make sure I get this done quickly, but it's flying along.
Yeah, you really.
It's really coming along beautifully, and I just... Oh my God, I really love the way the yarn is.
The less stress of January allows you to do things.
It is. All right. Oh, God, put that back in.
I still have...
7 whips.
I think 3.
Really?
Yeah. Okay, so we have a Ravelry page.
Oh!
Called the Crafty Toads Ravelry page, and that actually fits in.
Right. I forgot about that.
And way back... probably October, maybe November. Musing Runner from the Tome Time Reading and Knitting podcast put up on her Instagram feed that she was picking her colors for her Joker. She's going to do the Joker and the Thief shawl. And I commented and said, oh my God, I really want to do that. And she said, oh, should we do a shared knit along? And we both decided that with the holidays and everything to push it off until January.
So, I would like to say that she has been much, much better about promoting this and everything because she has actually podcast.
I was going to say she's actually podcast
right.
to do it. So we have a cowl that we are doing from January 1st through March 15th, and we are calling it the Lyrical Cowl. So you may join. All you have to do is link your project to song lyrics of some sort, just because the Joker and the Thief is the... Jimi Hendrix.
Along the Watchtower?
Yeah.
Written, by the way, by Bob Dylan.
Yes. So, on January 1st, I cast on... Well, first I had to pick my colors. So
You have, well, you probably do know what goes into trying to pick your colors.
So I had to pick my colors and...
7 of them.
Yeah. So it was a little bit of stash diving into both mine and, you know, Mary Beth's stash.
I can't tell you how close we came to just doing a fade.
Oh, God, I really want to do my find my fade. Anyway.
Lemmings! You are lemmings! We have no problem accepting that.
To begin with, I saw it and I'm like, I really didn't like it. And then I see everybody putting out there, and some people's choices, I mean, some people are just going with the neon choices and some people are just going with choices that are not my particular color choices. And then others like,
Yarn Hoarders got
beautiful colors. I was going to say, Amber from the Yarn Hoarders got beautiful pastels. Who has all the pastels? Somebody's got pastels. Maybe Circus Tonic.
I actually found a picture of a sock that I fell in love with that I am now going to go and try and find the colors of the sock to make it into a Find Your Fade because I love the picture so much.
But that is...
Side pack. Can we do, like, is there something, a song lyric that has fade in it?
No, I'm doing the joke in the Z.
Good two, two.
Right.
Okay. I'm sorry. I forgot who we were talking about.
So, this is The Joker and the Thief. It's by Melanie Berg.
Another one of our favorite
designers. Right. We have done the Drakenfels, which I wear my Drakenfels almost every single day now that it's gotten cold. I never thought I was going to wear it that much.
I say she's one of our favorites. We've knit
one thing.
But we've saved a whole ton of hers.
I love her pattern. I love the way her finished shawls look. I love
the way she writes her patterns.
And the right way she writes her patterns. So, Joker and the Thief. And this is how far I've gotten. I have managed to work all 7 colors in. So the gray is my background color. It is an old skein of Zen garden yarn that I got as a gift. I can't tell you what it's made of. I think there is maybe some silk in there. But that is going to be, that's the background color. And then my color 1 is Little Brown Hair. Jelly Bean colorway that I got at New Jersey Sheep and Wool. Color 2.
Do you know which goes where?
I have it written down somewhere. Anyway. Color 2 is my Francophie Knit skein that very fittingly Stacy, Musing Runner, gave me in our book swap. Color 3 is my Fig Bash from Wool and Vine. Color 4 is Mary Beth's. That's it. I went stash diving for both of us. Little Brown Hair.
Monet.
Watercolors.
Watercolors.
Skein that we got at New Jersey Sheep and Wool. Color 5 is Oink Pigment, which I got in my Fibershare package, and it's Pixie Wings.
Love the name of it.
Yeah. And then color 6 is Hedgehog Fibers Dragonfly that is Mary Beth's.
So, again, from Teresa.
From Teresa. So, all stuff that was, I didn't purchase, much as I may have wanted to. Just means I get to purchase for my fade. Anyway, so I am to the point now where everything is going to shift. It's got a very...
So have you done each of the 6 colors?
Yeah.
Oh.
So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6 is the last thing I've done.
Oh, wow.
It's got a very funky Indian cross... I think it's called the Indian cross stitch. Which, since it's paper pattern, I'm not going to go into the stitch. But it's very interesting. And I was very excited when Musing Runner put a picture of her Joker and the Thief up on Instagram earlier this week. I'm like, oh, look, thank God, your stitches look like mine.
I'm doing it right.
So, but now, so the gray has been the background up until now. And now what's going to happen is the colors become the background and the gray becomes the funky stitch. So, and then I will ultimately end again with like this repeat. So
it's really, really pretty.
It is. I'm very excited about the colors.
I can't wait to see the big blocks of colors
and
in
the big
it.
Yeah, getting the big blocks of colors going. So, and I mean,
these are gorgeous colors too.
Yeah,
so pretty.
Fun knits. I have actually a Ravelry page. I made a project for it.
That's another one of our, you know, goals for 2017 is to, you know, put things on Ravelry.
Where I have detailed what all the colors are and where they came from.
So. I need to put my picture up in the cowl. Mine
so come is... join our cowl because we will have, and then go over to Musing Tome Time Reading and Knitting's Ravelry page and join her. There'll be prizes from both sides. I know Legacy Knits is also doing a shawl knit along for January. So, I mean, there's going to be tons of
double and triple
dipping opportunities. So come join us.
Mine is Return to Pooh Corner. That's my song by Kenny Loggins. So that's how I'm tying mine in for my song. But
yeah, I mean, pick a project and I'm pretty sure with a little creativity, you can come up with some lyrics.
Yeah. So. It's cool.
So January 1st to March 15th.
Very exciting. I had been doing, up until January 1st, I had been doing a lot of straight vanilla knitting with the socks that I was doing and then the Mrs. Weasley sweater. It was just straight knitting. I'm so happy doing a pattern again.
Yeah.
I really love doing patterns.
Well, it's also your headspace is now to the point where you can follow a pattern. Right.
I can let things in.
This is what I really want to work on.
Let's just say down the rabbit hole, shall we?
I started it. This is my blanket. So, this is my scrap blanket. Now that our Mrs. Weasley is finishing up, as we knit the mini into the Mrs. Weasley, then I take the remainder and I put it in my scrap blanket. So I am just knitting a giant granny square. So I started out in the middle with the circle, and I'm just going around and around and around and around. And I just love it. And I was, the last time we podcast, I was, you can see the progress keeper here. So I've only gotten a couple rows in, but they're getting much bigger.
Quite a bit more yarn being used too.
Yeah, and you know, crocheting just inhales yarn. I adore the way the blanket looks.
How many of you are doing the granny stripe blanket?
Yeah.
Just putting it out there. How many of you are doing it? Because really, I want to do it now.
Yeah, we're
working
on it. I see
everybody do it, and I want
to
do it.
We have to go get crochet hooks. And I just love the idea of having blankets all over the place.
They look so pretty. They really do. Thrown
just
over the back of
the couch.
Couch.
Or
and,
just thrown. Or hanging on a ladder.
Right.
I mean, the thing is, this is getting big enough so that when I'm working on it, it's actually covering my lap, which is nice, except for, you know, when the demon spawn of Satan comes and sits on my lap and...
That would be Tabitha.
...needs me. And then starts kneading my blanket, and I'm like, oh, I'm never going to be able to put this out because... There's no place where there's no animal.
It's okay.
It is.
It's part of who we are.
It's. I have bought into it.
So the granny square, the stripey blanket is going strong.
Yeah. So
I think I'm going to start by
doing
a stripe.
The rows, I am doing the giant granny square. And then I think I'm going to do, there's a Spice of Life one that is all different stitches.
Oh, right. You showed me that. That's so pretty.
So that I think I'm going to start, in that one, I think I'm going to actually pick colors for.
Okay.
Do more in a worsted weight so it goes a little bit faster.
Okay. And it'll be nice and warm.
Right. And maybe
throw it over
it,
your bed.
Like a wool acrylic blend so that it will go in the wash and also it will not, you know, kill me when the animal ruins. So perfectly good. Heirloom. Which, by the way, I got a beautiful pillow for my birthday. And if you follow Mary Beth on Instagram, you may go see, and also I'm going to put the picture at the beginning of this podcast.
We were at DMV.
It wasn't even a month
We were at DMV renewing our licenses, and I came back because I needed extra ID. And I come in, and there are two dogs waiting for me at the front door. Their entire back ends are covered in feathers.
It was a really good pillow with really a lot of feathers.
There were so many of them.
And really, it was very amusing. I love my dogs. I'm like, Mary Beth said that we could sew up the bottom of the pillow, and most of the feathers were still in there, which you would never guess looking
for the
oh my god, at the floor.
The entire floor was covered in pillow and feathers. So there are feathers all over this house.
We're about to get a visit.
Sorry.
She heard her name. So it was all very funny, and, you know, oh, well, we'll just go get the...
This is Tabitha.
Did I mention the demon spawn? It's nice to blow me out there, Tab. Oh, my God, Tabitha, get your...
This is Tabitha Stanley. She is our one of our cats. If you didn't meet her last week, this is her. Hi.
She and Mary Beth have an interesting relationship.
As you can hear.
Yep, that's there you Tabitha. Go.
Okay.
Anyway. I can wrap Tabitha in clothes. I can do whatever I want. Mary Beth looks at her funny and she hisses. So, anyway. We had the feather disaster, which we had to end up... We were going to use the canister vacuum and just suck it right up. And it would have been fine. And yeah, no. The feathers got stuck in the tube. And we had to finally get a stiff broom and sweep the rug... feathers into the kitchen so we could sweep them up, and then it's just a disaster. And then the big vacuum broke.
Anyway, it's not a good afternoon.
No.
But got our driver's licenses renewed
and our car registration,
and the feathers have been contained and the pillow's been sewn up,
and the dogs would like you all to know that nobody died, which is really the important thing,
right? Pillow did not attack us in the middle of the night. It has been subdued. Okay, what else have you got?
So, this really isn't a whip.
No, it's not.
I have caked a ball.
this is an accomplishment at some point.
I'm going to start. I may cast it on today. My hat. This is Nooch Fibers. 100% superwash merino, 100 grams, 400 yards. It is called the toilet, which I just it amuses me. It is based on a piece of artwork named the toilet, so which is what Nooch does. They're a local dyer, and I'm going to. It's going to be my all local hat because it's. We showed you the Winter Whites book that we bought. And I'm going to do the broken rib hat with this. And I really want a hat because it's cold. So.
And we knit hats for everybody else. Time right. To knit a hat
now
for us.
Time to knit a hat for me. So hopefully I will cast that on. So,
okay.
That is, I believe, my whips.
All right. Are we done?
We're done, whips.
All right. We do want to mention quickly that we got a couple of Christmas swaps that came. I got mine from Cheryl. Thank you so much. She sent us these. And she sent us the treats that kept the dogs occupied for a few minutes at the beginning. And a whole bunch of other stuff. Trust me, Cheryl can pack a box.
Oh, yeah.
She does such a good job. You get a box that's like this big, and it is jam-packed full of stuff.
Every inch is used.
Oh, my God. She sent us napkins that her husband made, and all sorts of papers, and little gadgety tools and things, and yarn.
Sent me a stocking full of chocolate.
And chocolate.
And
it was beautiful.
A lovely snowman pin.
Thank you. Oh, do you know what? I wore my snowman pin all through Christmas, and I got so many comments on it. So thank you so much, Cheryl. I'm sorry we're not showing everything. It's just
there's so much to do,
and
in the episode.
Time.
So,
but thank you very much.
Plus, we've opened and used. I mean, the chocolate is.
Yeah. That barely made it out of the day.
We did make the dogs wait for their treats because it is their bribe, which you know, as you can tell, worked really well, but. I got my package, my Christmas pop package from Stacy, Thank you very much. I loved everything in it. She sent me a journal. She worked with Mary Beth in secret to make sure that she got me all stuff that I like, which was very sweet of her.
Yeah, it was so nice. Thank you.
And it came just in time for Christmas.
Yep.
So it was perfect. And I got lots of new minis to add to my sweater.
And thank you guys and everybody who sent us stuff. Thank you so much for including the other one. Because when we send packages, you know, it's so nice when one person gets a package and there's something in it for the other one. It's always so sweet.
And I mean, not
that we expected it.
Or and it's just so
it's
so
always nice. Surprise. But thank you so much for including everybody.
And Stacy did include a set of stitch markers that will be one of the prizes for our giveaway.
Oh, cool. So. Right. Also, Cheryl included the cats and the dogs, which is very, very nice.
Very appreciated, even though they're not really good at showing it.
They do appreciate it. Thank you so much. And we made it through Christmas. And we had a very, very nice Christmas with the family. I did get a couple of presents that I wanted to share just because they fit in with what we're doing. So one of the presents...
One of them was an unexpected source.
One of the things I got is I got a crock pot. So we're going to start using that for dyeing yarn. But I helped my mom pick that out, so that wasn't a surprise. But my sister, other sister Amanda, gave me Eat Like a Gilmore Girl, which fits in totally perfectly with this community that we are in. So it's a cookbook that we can do, that we can make all sorts of things. It also fits in very well with our New Year's plans, but it's the unofficial cookbook for fans of the Gilmore Girls, and I believe somebody said it's the next best thing to having Suki there. So,
and it tells you which character... it's based on, like, so that, I mean, the higher end recipes are like Suki recipes. There's some from Emily's Kitchen. It's really, it's a fun book. And there are
actually Luke Steiner and some things.
Things that we want to make and eat.
Oh, yeah. No, there's lots of really good stuff in here.
It's not all coffee.
French toast.
I kind of thought it was going to be all coffee.
Founder's Day Punch, salmon puffs, risotto, all sorts of really good things. Patty melts. Oh, I love patty melts. Anyway. Really, really
we will keep
good
you
stuff.
Posted to our progress of cooking our way through Gilmore Girls.
My sister Amanda gave me this, and it was just so fun. And then my brother Larry gave us two books for knitting. This is Knitting from the North, and it is all different patterns and ideas for
Nordic
kind of things. Here's
absolutely gorgeous
the back, so that you can see some of the ideas. It is...
And it's going to be all new techniques for us, because we're not generally color workers or Fair Isle or anything, so...
Knitting from the North, original designs inspired by Nordic and Fair Isle knitting traditions by Hillary Grant is the author of it. There are such pretty things in here. I mean, really, really pretty. Here are tied mittens. Okay, I can't see. Can you see?
Yeah, you're good.
Okay. So that's... one thing, and then on the next page, it gives you the chart that you need for it, and it gives you all the instructions and stuff. All sorts of really, really, really.
Is that a beret?
It is. It's the tied beret. Look at that. How pretty is that?
I'm gonna make that. I mean, I'm gonna cast it on tomorrow.
You sure you don't want to do it tonight?
this afternoon.
Just gorgeous, gorgeous. Look at this.
Look at those colors.
Loki. The Loki hat. So, I mean, really fun things. We haven't had a chance to go through it in depth, but great patterns.
And new techniques, because one of the things I want to do this year is kind of expand my...
on the straight knit and purl and that sort of thing.
Right.
Excuse me. So, I'm very excited to work on this. So also, that... it's going to tie in with, you know, sweaters, because I want to do sweaters.
That is, and then he gave us the more humorous side.
Excuse me, I'm just reaching for my glass.
Knits for kittens. Or kitties. So this has 25 cat toys that we can make. And this kind of fits in with the other Naughty Knitwit knit along that we're doing. They are doing a year long.
Stuff it.
And the idea is make little stuffies that you can either use as ornaments or whatever. because you get to December and you think, oh, I'm going to knit ornaments for my Christmas tree. And
you have no time.
And you have no time to do it. So now you're doing one a year or one a month. So, I mean, you got little mice. Mice. I hate when people do it too.
It's like, here we go, ready?
Here. And the one I'm going to do first, because I may send it down to Virginia, is the spider. So, this is going to be lots of fun.
So much fun. And the great thing about this is, these are going to be something that you can whip out in an afternoon. I mean, like...
Like the spider, I think probably will take like 20 minutes.
Really, really easy to do, but great to have around, you know, and you can use them to send to nephews or give to your cats, because we
could
cats.
Actually give one to our cats. I do kind of like them. Get a shrimp.
Move over towards me a little.
Do the pattern. This is going to be lots of fun. So
yes.
Next week we will have 20 done.
Okay.
And then our sister, our other sister.
Amanda, again, the one that gave me the Gilmore Girls.
Gave us, there's a kit, it's a kit, but this is the book that comes in the kit.
We have two nephews, one age 5, one age 2.5.
Both boys.
Ask the 2.5-year-old, who are you? Superman. Superman.
We were Batman. Watching the Lego Batman that's on Netflix. Oh my god, I thought he was going to split my eardrum for the beginning part because it shows all the different characters and it was Batman! Flash! Screaming at the top. Superman! Superman! He got so excited.
He's so excited about this. So
I think he's seen it 6 billion times, but...
We will be sending some of these to Virginia because they are just awesome. But you can do... They have got... How many different ones do they have? They've got...
I think 12.
Including Groot from Guardians of the Galaxy. We can make Falcon, Ant-Man, Thor, Hawkeye. I mean, there are a whole bunch of them. Iron Man, including Spider-Man and... Captain America.
Yeah. Which came in the Spider-Man and Captain America tools came in a kit.
So we have to figure out this whole crochet thing. And, well, actually, I have to figure out this whole crochet
thing. I do too. I mean, I know how to do a granny square, but this teeny tiny, like, amigurumi.
But it's not going to take you terribly long. And then you can make Black Widow.
And Hawkeye.
And Hawkeye. So, oh, here, look. Really? How can you not? Right. So. Next week, we'll
have 20.
Well, we may have started one.
This one is something that I can't do in front of the TV. I mean, especially to begin with.
Right, you need to pay attention.
We really need to pay attention. So,
but fun things to do. Yeah. Really, really fun things. So it was
maybe
just...
during our snow.
Yeah.
Our Snowmageddon, you know, we're going to get like 3 inches.
If that.
Oregon, there was a picture of the Oregon police station.
Oh, really?
It's like buried in snow.
And we're worrying about the fact that we're getting 2 inches. Dusting.
Oh. I'm bitching last night because we're in the dark blue area that's getting the most snow. It's like 1 to 3 inches.
Oh, man. Okay. All right.
Moving on.
So, tomorrow, we have set aside tomorrow as a dye day. We're going to try and get some... We have had a request for Faded Gypsies again, which we have to see if we can reproduce. But we did do a little bit of dyeing, and we got...
We got two new colors.
Out and online. So Instead of doing Faded Gypsies, we have Gypsy Caravan, and that is this one. It's the same colorway, but much brighter.
And I will, you will have already seen at the beginning of the podcast the pictures that we took for online, which have it in the hank form.
So
you can see all the different colors. But that's Gypsy Caravan. And then we have Dragon Scales, which is this one. Both gorgeous.
Yes. So. And we got a new yarn that is 80-20. It's 80 superwash merino, 20 nylon. So it's kind of plumper. Mm-hmm. A little bit plumper. So it's we have those. So those are ready to go. And then tomorrow we're working on... we're going to do the Faded Gypsies and a couple of other new ones. So now we have...
And the original Dragon Scales, we're going to try and get that.
Right.
And we have some DK weight that we're going to try out. So
it's exciting times. Yeah. We have some time. We got everything done, so we get to dye tomorrow. So yeah. Very excited. But the Dragon Scales and the Gypsy Caravan are online right now if you're interested. And
the Vintage Candy is still online because we have some of that left.
Yes.
And
I'm probably going to be doing
Tika
more of that.
Tika may still be up, too.
Okay. All right. So that's pretty much all the yarn stuff. We are just going to do a quick, what we've been doing otherwise, reading, writing.
Got to read a little bit.
Yes. Oh my gosh. January 1st, I sat down and started a book. Well, actually, I sat down and started on January 1st and finished it January 2nd. Went right through it. It was such a good book. It's called The Bookshop on the Corner. It's by Jenny Colgan. It was so much fun. Loved it. About a girl who moves to Scotland and opens a bookmobile. I mean, let's start with the fact that it's just, you know, what I want to do. But
including the whole moving to Scotland part.
Yeah. But it was just, it was so much fun. It's definitely like a chick lit book. It's got elements of chick lit in it, but it was just great. And she recommends books throughout it, and it was really, really good. So really like that one. And then I had read, for our book club, we're doing a mystery, and we had to read a book that's, you know, just pick a mystery. Lisa, the friend who gave us The Snowman, she gave me this book to read. It is Absent in Spring by Mary Westmacott, who is actually Agatha Christie, who I love.
Who we did not realize wrote a whole series of...
Under a pseudonym, yeah.
They call it romance. But.
It was really very good. Really very good. It was written in 1944, so it was very interesting because it's just around the beginning of the Second World War, and that ties into it a little bit. Very, very, very good. So I finished this. I'm telling you.
She's a book hog.
You give me a little bit of time where I'm not falling asleep all the time and I'm having a ball.
She's read 3 books. I am still working on my first. Then I started back in the beginning of December.
This is
the readers, I'm reading as much as she is.
The readers of Broken Wheel recommend.
This was on a list.
By Katarina Biebold.
One of those year-end lists that we ran into, so we got it for Christmas.
Well, my mom takes us to the bookstore, and she's like, okay, we need to get books for everybody. And we, throughout the year, make lists for ourselves of all the different books that we find that we think sound interesting. So this was one of them. And this is about a woman who comes over from Sweden to visit somebody in Iowa, Broken Wheel, Iowa, only to find out that she's walking in on the woman's funeral, and... what she decides to do, will she stay in Iowa or go back to Sweden and that sort of thing. But it's all about reading in books and bookstores and things like that. So I'm loving it. It's fantastic. Really, really, really enjoying it. So those are my books. That's what I'm reading.
Mine's much shorter. I'm almost done. I'm like down to like the last 10 pages of The Lake House by Kate Morton.
You're that close?
Yeah.
And you're not over there reading?
Well, it's all kind of come together now so that it's just kind of, I'm into the point where they're weaving in the final ones, but I know how it's going to play out. It's a fantastic book.
I love Kate Morton.
It's, she's got wonderful characters, always a gorgeous house.
I know, there's always at least one awesome house in it.
The Lake House, you just see yourself in Cornwall in the gardens and the Lake House, and it goes between... 3 different time periods, so that you keep jumping back and forth between like the 30s and the present day and then the First World War. Very sad, but very, very good.
Yeah, it's very a good. Really, really good book. I read it, and it's...
I'd show it, but I'm reading it on the Nook, so...
Kate Morton, if you see anything by her,
yeah.
Strongly recommend.
It's only the second one that I've read, just because I don't...
You haven't read... that's really only the second one?
Yeah, I think I did The Forgotten Garden and that's it.
Oh, you have all these great books. Yeah.
But, you know, the one that I read was when everybody was doing the twin...
Right.
The unknown twin and or the unknown triplets or whatever. So I was just like, really, another one? So, anyway. But I love it. And it's in... Towards the end of the year, I was only being able to read like 10 minutes before I fell asleep. And now I'm getting reading time in the morning, and it's just...
It's really nice.
Reading and knitting, and it's just, I'm really surprised I'm getting anything done.
Yes. So. Yeah. It's very nice. And working from home actually kind of plays into that, because you don't have to be anywhere at a certain time, so mm-hmm. that if you start work at noon instead of at 10.
You just have to work that much later.
Right. So. As long as you get your stuff done. All right.
TV.
Watching. What have we been watching? Oh, we talked about how we went through a couple of Aussie series. My brother finds these esoteric series and gives them to us for Christmas. Last year he gave us 800 words, the season one of 800 words. And this year he gave us season two.
It's so good.
We love the show. We really love the show.
I think we did the entire season. I mean, it's
Megan,
only,
do you
it's
know
only,
the show?
Yeah.
Because I think of you when we watch it.
Especially
and I'm wondering,
since it's set in New Zealand. And
so
I'm
is
like,
your town like that?
Right. Do you live in Weld?
Yeah.
Because I want to live in Weld.
Oh my God. It's so good. It's about this guy.
All the crazy people.
Who loses his wife and decides
it's
that.
It's a real, you know, ha ha.
He decides he's taking his two teenage children and he's going to move to New Zealand and get away from Australia, where his life was with the family there. And he's going to buy the house that he spent time in as a child when he would go on vacation with his grandparents. And he
and
buys the house
there.
And it turns out to be a completely different house. It isn't even finished.
He buys the house on the internet.
Unseen. Different country.
Grief does weird things to people. They lose all their belongings on the trip over. It's just the characters in this little beach town.
It's so cool.
Oh, it's so fun.
Really, really cool. So 800 words.
The second season within 2 days.
Yeah.
And then he gave us, this year he gave us Doctor Doctor, which is Australian as well. Again, very character driven, weirdos. Just a lot of fun.
Yeah, really, really good stuff. We really enjoyed that. It. Had a lot of fun with that.
And right now we are watching Travelers.
Almost done season one of Travelers.
Netflix, which is really very interesting.
It has Will from Will and Grace.
To get our
being
second.
Very not Will.
Yes.
Very much not Will. However, very good. Really, really good.
A lot of fun.
Yes, really enjoying that one.
And then...
We caught up on a couple of shows that we missed part of during this regular season. So we got caught up on Madam Secretary and Life in Pieces. Okay. If you don't watch Life in Pieces.
And you have, you know, siblings.
You have to watch it.
This is a show, and there are not a lot of them out there, that will make me, you know, snort my drink.
Yeah. It
just
is so
every
funny.
Single time.
Yeah, it's so good. Extended
and
family.
You all have.
You will recognize.
You all have those family members, you know? It's just...
You will definitely recognize people in this show. Oh, it's so much fun. It really is. It's hysterically funny. It's a half-hour sitcom. But definitely, if you can, find
Catch
Life
it.
In Pieces. Really, really, really good.
Forgot how to drink.
See? Okay.
That's so funny. You're not going to find it funny at all. But just remember us when you're watching it.
Okay.
All right. And we are huge fans of the Great British Bake Off and miss it desperately. But then there's an American one that they did this year for the holidays. So we've been watching that.
They did it last year too. So this is the second season.
And then the other night we were going into YouTube to watch a podcast. I'm like, what's that? What is that there? And it was the Great Christmas Bake Off.
And they did two
it was
episodes.
The British Bake Off where they brought back old contestants. Only That's four, so but oh my God.
Oh, it's so good.
There are two episodes that are like an hour each.
They're in YouTube. Yeah. So they're the Great Christmas Bake Off. So if you are fans of the Great British Bake Off,
find their YouTube channel and it's there.
Yeah, because they're so much fun.
It was such a treat the other day. It was like, what's that?
Yeah, we get very excited about it. So we did that. All right.
We have under a minute before the iPad shuts down again.
All right, here we go, quickly. Upcoming plans. We have been talking about doing a yarn club now that we're dyers. You know, we've dyed, seven?
Four colors.
So yarn, we're dyers now. But we want to do a yarn club, and we're going to have more information about it in the next episode because we're
finalizing all the pieces.
Yeah, getting everything finished up. But you're going to be able to do 1 month, 3 months, or 6 months.
It'll be a mystery.
Yes.
Colorway that you get to see when your package arrives. But we have a whole plan.
We have ideas.
We do. And it's going to be great.
It's cool. It's
really hopefully cool. It'll be ready so that you buy your first installment in February.
Yes. So that will be coming up.
So we'll have more about that. And we are going to podcast more regularly.
Oh, yes.
Now that...
Crazy December is over.
You gotta lose it.
Technical difficulties again. The iPad keeps crapping out on us.
40-minute recording time. So I happen to know that we are now two sets of 40 minutes, so this is going to be a long one.
Well, if you've made it this long, you know
it's going to be a long one.
So we came back for the last, you know...
Goodbye.
So long.
Farewell.
I bid you to see you.
Okay. So, goodbye.
Anyway. So Yarn Club, that will be coming up. We'll talk more about it next time and have everything up and ready to go so that if you're interested.
We'll have all the details. Yeah.
But it's going to be exciting because we're really,
we're very excited.
We are very excited about it. It's going to be really fun. So that's coming up. And I think really that is it. We've been chatting your ear off for an hour and 20 minutes. So I figure
we should let you go.
Yeah. You've got stuff to do.
It's January. Gotta go to the gym.
Sorry. Okay.
So we gotta get going to the go forth and knit stage.
All right, everybody, go forth and knit.
Go forth and knit.
Have a great week, and hopefully we will be on top of things, and we will see you next week. Oh, and I'm gonna have different color hair by then.
Hair appointment Sunday.
We have been trying to do this since 2 weeks before Christmas, and I think we actually are finally going to get it done. And
new colorways in the work.
Yep, it's going to be awesome. My mother, we were shopping with her, and she turned around to me, and she was behind me in line, and she's like, "I just don't recognize you with your hair like that." And then she looks at me and she's, "I feel so sorry for your
hair." She goes through stages.
No idea.
Where she's like, really. You think she's kind of looking at you and you're like, she's kind of intrigued by it. And then it's others. And then our other sister just doesn't even mention it. You just catch her looking at you. And it's like, yeah.
Yeah, the rest of our family doesn't get us.
You know, my staid brother. What did you do? Whatever. Live a little.
So, yeah. Oh my God. Anyway.
Midlife crisis. It's fun.
Yeah. It's not a midlife crisis.
My true self.
Yes, we are expressing ourselves through our hair. We were doing a show, and there was a lady across the room who had blue going through her hair. And I went up to her and I said, so what color is yours? And she said, you know, we can spot each other. Creative types. So, okay. Have a great week, everybody. Yes. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy everything. Kwanzaa, Diwali, Hanukkah, you know, everything. We hope you made it through your holidays in one piece. And you're still speaking to all your family members. We did. Touch and go there for a while. No, I'm just kidding.
Some of them overstayed their welcome. Anyway, go forth and knit, everybody.
So long.